Hi, I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst of Chatterbox Quilts. Today, I'm going to show you how to do a French knot. I like to use French knots in my projects because they give lots of texture and interest. They make really cute little flowers, but I also use them in other ways, and I'll show you some projects after I show you the technique, and you can see what I mean. What I'm doing first, of course, is coming up from the back of my piece, as I always do. Now, I'm going to hold the thread with my left hand because I'm right-handed. If you are left-handed, you'll be holding with your right hand. And then what I'm doing is I'm laying the needle on top of the thread and winding the thread around the needle. The number of times you twist that thread around the needle will give you the size of the French knot. So if I put, say, six, if I twist around six times, it's going to be a great big knot. Usually I do about three times. I find that works pretty well. So now I've got those three twists around the needle. I'm holding that thread, I'm holding it taut here. I don't want those twists to come off the needle. And then I'm taking the needle right back very close, or probably can't get in the same spot, but very close to where I came out. And then I'm pushing it back down. I'm still holding the yarn here because that's what's gonna, or the thread I should say, that's what's gonna give me that knot. Still holding, still holding, still holding. Oh, you can let go. As it gets closer, when you're pulling it down, there's just a little bit of thread left. At that point in time, you can let go. And it makes this nice little knot. So let's try again. Come up from underneath, hold that yarn off to the side, lay your needle across the top, on top of the thread I should say. Let's see if I can wind it a few more times and see what it looks like. So while you're holding it taut, you have to make sure it's not so tight that you can't move the needle around to get it back down the hole. So it's a little bit of practice on this one. Hold it. Go right back down. Sometimes it's a little hard to get that eye down because it's so big. And you can see how much bigger that is. It's a lot higher than the first one. So again, if you are wanting to make a big knot, just wind it more times around the needle. If you have a thicker thread, I'm working with a 12 purl cotton here, so if you had, say, for example, a 3 purl cotton, which is a much thicker thread, you don't need to wind it as many times around the needle because you're going to, just because of the width of the thread, the thickness of the thread, you're going to get a much bigger knot anyway. So that's the French knot, and I'll just show you in one of the projects that I'm working on right now what I've done with the French knot. So they look really cute when you put them together into a group, as I've done here. So that's what you'll see a lot of times, that they're put together in a little group and they make like a little flower, or even the flower centers. It's really quite effective for that. Here I've used them by themselves just as an added little part around this chain stitch. So there they are separately. And then the other thing I've done is in this particular area, a couple of them here, I have actually put the French knots in the open spaces of the chain stitch. So that gives it some extra texture, some more interest. So very effective. So three different uses of them, all very effective. So practice with the French knot. It might take a little while to get it down. Don't be discouraged. It'll come. It definitely is a design that you have to practice to get it right. So give it a try, and I'm sure you'll enjoy adding lots of little French knots to your embroidery projects.